Hello everyone, this is Jason. Welcome back to my class. Today we will learn floor design skills. In this course, we will understand the design logic of floors and master the common floor types in our design tool. We will explore various paving methods with different materials and textures for floors and the incorporation of steps with light strips. So we have previously covered the difference between the wall adding and the paving in our wall design skill course. You can make a quick review for that course. And as for the design steps, basically they are following the same steps, okay? So you need to draw the area by using the reference line and then using the drawing features to draw different type of shapes. And you need to extrude it and add some light strip if you want, okay? And also you can apply with the material for the elevation. And then you can change for the materials patterns and the size, okay? And then you can just save it as a template if you want. So let's just get into our case restoration. So the first case is our wooden floor design. As you can see in this case, the key operation for this one is you just need to select the floor design paving method, okay, in our paving edit. So let's just get into our design tool. Click the floor, get into the floor edit. As you can see, the interface are similar like the wall and ceiling edit. So they are following the same design skills in this page. So we can click this one and find the paving method. Okay, this one. And also you can see we have some settings for this paving. You can control with this start point in the middle or in the corner, and also you can change the horizontal offset. As for the gap, you can change as a true gap or false gap and change the gap's width and for its color. Okay, so that's for the gap setting, and also for the patterns, you can change the size. So I got these patterns, and after we finish about this case, let's see the next case. So in this case, we have these tiles on the floor. Okay, we can just try to find the material with the tiles. Okay, maybe this one, and you can apply on the floor. And also you can add to your favorite if you like this tile. So click here, also you can change for its paving and control with the textures or its gaps if you want. Okay, then let's just get into our next case. In this case, we have two different area applied with two different textures, right? One is for wooden, another is for the tiles. So we just need to draw the shape for the wooden one, use rectangle. And also you can just apply with a wooden floor on this side. So that's for this case. And let's see the next case with a wave line on the floor. Okay, so you can see these are border tiles on the floor. So we have a feature in our paving edit. So if you want to create some complicated paving method, you need to go into the paving edit. It's very important. So let's just choose this area and click add paving. So click here, you see we have this whole circle border tile. When you click it and click confirm, it will generate a whole circle border tile. Okay, and after you choose this border tile, you can change with some properties. Like if you want this corner with corner or without corner, okay? So you can see the difference. And also can change for the gaps, for the color, and also for the size if you want, and for the patterns for this border tile. And in that case, it's not close to the wall, so we can offset it, make it into the middle, okay? And also we can add more border tile if you want. So you can click here, confirm, and we generate another border tile. So we can change for its corner and click here. we can change the width and offset a little bit and just create another border tile. Click here, change the width and offset a little bit. So that's for this case. We just finish about these three border tile on the floor. Okay. And also we have the next case with a water jet in the middle. So it's very easy. You can just find it in our catalog. So click the model catalog, find water jet pattern, choose the water jet pattern as you want. Okay. I just want to choose this one, apply it here. Say, and also you can just change for its size to stretch it. And also you can just change dimensions on the left panel. Okay, it's more accurate. So that's for this case. So let's see the next one. So in this case, you can see we have some steps in the living room with light strips. Okay, so we can just draw the area and set light strip for the steps. So we can use the rectangle. And we can use the straight line to divide this area into two steps. Okay, and set extrusion for these two steps. And after the extrusion, we need to apply with the material on the steps. So we can find a material, like I want to choose the stone to apply on it. And don't forget about the elevation. So you can see in this small navigator, we don't have material on the steps elevation. So we can click this line and set the elevation. We can apply with the material. So sometimes you find it's hard to find the last material. So you can just click here and add to your favorites. Then we click the line and add elevation. Finding your account, apply this material on the elevation. Click down. And we also have light strip, remember? And click this line. We can set with the lamp out in here. Also, you can change for its trough size. Okay, we can just make it smaller. Click down, and also you can just click here, duplicate for the next steps. Okay, so you can make a quick review in this small navigator. Okay, and that's for this case. So and we also can save our design into a template. So next time, if you want to use it, you can quickly call it from your personal account. So send logic, you can click here and save all as template. Okay, even then, and click down, we'll show with a rendering process on the left panel. Okay, just wait a second. And sometimes, as you can see, if you want to copy this material to the rest area, and sometimes you find there is a door sill on the walls, right? So you want to apply the materials. You see, it can't apply the material on the doors area. So you can click this area. You will see there is a small button, and then you can click this one. So the patterns will apply on this area with a continuous patterns. Okay, so that's for the floor. And also sometimes you find the gaps for the floor is not in the correct paving. So you can go into the edit paving, click this one, and we can make this gap clear. You can just use this one with a gap snapping. Okay, you can just use as a smart gap snapping or use manually. So you can click here to just move a little bit for this gap. And also you can use the gap snapping intelligent. Okay, So I can show you if we have two different area and apply with the same material, but they don't align with the gaps. So we can use this one, gap snapping smartly. So you can see we can align the gap and smartly, okay. So that's for the gap snapping. So at the end of class, I want to make a summary for design steps. So first step, you need to determine whether the shape is extruded. Okay, then we need to draw the area, go pave editing if there is complicated paving. Then we choose the paving method, or you can choose from your enterprise library. Okay, and we can modify with properties for its patterns and for the gap. And also we can add some details to the shape, like wanna add with light strip, implied material on the elevation. And the last step is you can seam up the paving gap and connect the wall surface or the floor surface in the material and component. Okay. So that's all for today's class. So in the end, we have an assignment for you guys. We have a floor assignment, as you can see here. We have some steps with light strip and also with a platform, okay? So the requirement for this assignment is you need to set the area and draw the shape. Extrude the stairs from the floor, apply with the light strip. Okay, so that's for today's class.